dear students, welcome back to maths. Now, all these years you have learned about the mathematical operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Okay, so today I am going to introduce to you a new topic or new branch of mathematics, that is nothing but algebra. Okay, so we are going to study a new lesson today, that is preparation for algebra. What does algebra mean? You have learned about the mathematical operations of, you know, addition of the numbers, multiplication of numbers, subtraction of numbers and even division of numbers. Whereas algebra is the branch of mathematics in which numbers as well as letters are used together to form certain problems. Okay, I'll repeat. Algebra is the branch of mathematics in which numbers as well as letters are used to form some problems. So you will learn how we can have different operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication and division with the use of numbers as well as letters. Okay, so let's try to learn about algebra. Now you have learned that whenever we add or subtract or multiply or divide any number, whatever answer we are getting is the number itself. For example, if we consider the number such as sum of 6 and 4. Okay, I'll write here sum of 6 and 4. 6 and 4 is nothing but is 10, correct? As well as the difference between 6 and 4, the difference between 6 and 4 is 2, correct? This you have learned. And in a simple manner, instead of writing them in words, we also can write this as 6 plus 4 is equal to 10, correct? 6 plus 4 is equal to 10. And here 6 minus 2 is equal to 4. Sorry, 6 minus 4 is equal to 2, correct? So, we know that when we are writing like this, when we add the numbers or subtract the numbers, we are getting answer as the numbers itself, correct? So, we are getting numbers when we add or subtract or maybe multiply or divide, we are always getting numbers. Now, let us think in a different manner now. Suppose we have to get a certain number, like let's suppose that number is 14, okay? That number is 14, okay? So, if we want to get a number 14 by different mathematical operations, we can get this number 14 by adding, subtracting, dividing as well as multiplying. So, let's see how we can get 14, okay? By doing all these mathematical operations. Let's suppose 14, first we'll do addition, then subtraction, multiplication and division. So we can get 14 by adding as 8 plus 6, okay? 8 plus 6 is equal to 14, okay? 8 plus 6 is equal to 14. Then by subtraction, how we can get 14? You can get anyhow. So I'll use, suppose 16 minus 2 is also equal to 14, correct? 16 minus 2 is also equal to 14. Then we will take multiplication. So multiplication, how we can do multiplication? You can take any numbers. I take 14 only. 14 multiplied by 1 is also equal to 14. Correct? 14 multiplied by 1 is also equal to 14. And last, I can take division as 28 divided by 2, okay, is also equal to 14. Correct? Now we have got number 14 in different operations, that is by doing addition,
subtraction, multiplication as well as division, all the answers are same, correct? That is 14. And if you see carefully, I have written these pair of numbers, okay? These are all pair of numbers. These pair of numbers, I have written them in the bracket, okay? Now, what is the use of this bracket? Now, whenever any numbers are the numbers which are written in the bracket, okay? They are called as terms, okay? Whenever any pair of numbers are written in the bracket, we call them as terms, okay? So, therefore, we can say that 8 plus 6 is nothing but a term, okay? 16. For our convenience, we write them in the bracket. And when we write them, these pairs of numbers in the bracket, we call this whole bracket with this pair of numbers as term. Is that clear, students? Why we are using the bracket is, when we want to say that a number obtained by adding 8 and 6 is 14, okay? A number obtained by adding 8 and 6, so I can write this in words as a number obtained by adding, okay, 8 and 6 is 14, okay? It is easier for us to express them in the form of a bracket. Similarly, what we can say over here is that a number obtained by subtracting 2 from 16, okay? We can also say this as a number, this is that number which is obtained after subtracting 2 from 16. Okay, again it becomes easier for us to write them in the form of a bracket, this whole expression, a whole term. Then we can say over here, a number obtained by multiplying 14 with 1 or 1 with 14. Or we can also say that a number obtained by dividing 28 by 2. Okay, so all these can be written in a simple manner by the use of bracket. And when they are written in the bracket like this, okay, the pairs of numbers, when they are written in the bracket, it is also called as a term, okay? So they are also called as terms. So each of these, that is 8 plus 6, 16 minus 2, 14 multiplied by 1 and 28 by 2 are all called as terms. Is that clear, students? So arrangement like these are also called as terms, or another name for this is expressions. Okay, so the value of each of these, if you see, value of each of these expressions or terms is 14. Correct? So value of each of these terms or expressions is 14. That means what can you say about them? So we can say that all these expressions or all these terms are equal, correct? All these terms or all these expressions are equal to each other. So how we can write this? So we can also write this as, we can also write this as like this. 8 plus 6 is equal to 16 minus 2, correct? 8 plus 6 is also equal to 16 minus 2 because their value is same. After adding and subtracting, you are getting the same answer. That means what we can say about these? We can say that 8 plus 6 is equal to 16 minus 2. Also, we can say that, comma I put here, 8 plus 6 is also equal to 14 multiplied by 1. Okay, what we can say? 8 plus 6 is equal to 16 minus 2. Also, 8 plus 6 is equal to 14 multiplied by 1. Also, we can write this as 8 plus 6 is equal to last one, that is 28 divided by 2. So, we can write what? We can also write this as 28 divided by 2. Okay, so that means all these expressions are equal to each other. So what another way how we can write it as, we can also write it as, you know, we have seen now 8 plus 6 is equal to 16 minus 2. So what we can say now about 16 minus 2, we can also say that 16 minus 2 is equal to 14 multiplied by 1. 16 minus 2 is also equal to 28 divided by 2. What we can say about is 14 multiplied by 1 is also equal to 28 divided by 2, and so on. 28 divided by 2 is also equal to 8 plus 6. That means whenever now we write such expressions, okay, when we can also write this such expressions, that is 8 plus 6 is equal to 16 minus 2, or 8 plus 6 is equal to 14 multiplied by 1 is also called as equality. Equality means all these terms are equal. Why? Because their answers, when you are adding, subtracting, multiplying or dividing, you are getting the same answer. That means all these terms are equal to each other, and we say that when they are, these expressions are equal, we say that they are having equality. They are having equality. So I am introducing a new term to you, that is equality. Okay, equality. That means all these terms, that is 8 plus 6 is equal to 16 minus 2, that means 8 plus 6 and 16 minus 2, okay, are also equalities. Now here also what we can say here is that 6 plus 4 is equal to 10. So this is also an equality. So what finally we can say is that in an equality, the quantities on, okay. So here if you find this and this is equal, okay, this and this are equal, because 8 plus 6 is 14. That means whatever is there on the left hand side is equal to the left right hand side. Correct. So these are equal. So you can call these as equalities. Okay, what you can call them as equalities. So hence, similarly here also what we can say is that 6 plus 4 is equal to 10 is an equality, because the answer on both the sides when you are getting is are equal. And we always represent them with the help of a sign called as equal to sign. So we have to write a sign like this. When this sign is written like this, we mean that whatever expression is there or whatever term is there on the left hand side is equal to the term on the right hand side. So this is nothing but, these are nothing but, they are called as equalities. So I hope so you have understood about what are equalities. Okay. So now what we will do is that we will go for the problem set number 54. If you have understood about all these things, now whatever I have told you, we will go for now the next part of the lesson, that is problem set number 54. Now let us try to solve problem set number 54. So what you do, you when I'm reading, you need to pay attention what I'm reading the question. Okay, now first question, using brackets. Okay, you have to use brackets. Using brackets, write three pairs of numbers whose sum is 13. Okay, use them to write three equalities. Okay, so what you have to do here is that you have to take three pairs of numbers and write them in the bracket, and when you're adding them, sum, the question is sum, that means addition. So when you're adding them, the answer should be 13. Fine. And you have to show them in the form of equalities also. Okay, so let's try writing the first question, or writing the answer of the first question, that you need to have three sums. Okay, three addition sums whose addition should be, or whose sum should be 13. Okay, so let's try this. Okay, so answer should be 13. Okay, I'll write 13 for the three pairs of numbers. Okay, now you have to think three pairs of numbers whose sum will be 13. So what can be that? So you can have 8 plus 5. Okay, one you can have is 8 plus 5 can be the answer. 8 plus 5 is equal to 13, right? So we have got the first sum or addition whose sum is 13. Okay, like that you can have anyone. Okay, I can also write as 10 plus 3. 10 plus 3 is also equal to 13, right? Then what else we can have? We can also have 12 plus 1 is also equal to 13. So we have designed 3 pairs of or 3 terms in which all 3 of them are having the same answers. That means 8 plus 5 itself is an equality, 10 plus 3 is also is an equality, and 12 plus 1 is also is an equality. Because you have learned that in an equality, the quantities on both the sides of equal to sign are equal. Okay, we have also learned that when these terms are having the same answer, the value of all these expressions or terms is equal, that means even each one of them are equal to each other. So we can write equality in this manner also. We can write equality in this manner also. That is 8 plus 5 is equal to 10 plus 3. Okay, this is first equality you can write. Second, you can write 8 plus 5 is also equal to 12 plus 1. Okay, we can also write the third one because we are asked to write 3 equalities. So what else we can write? We can also write this as 10 plus 3 is equal to 12 plus 1. Okay, isn't it easy, students? Very easy, right? So we have got equality in this manner also, that is on both the sides, the quantities on both the sides are equal. So this is also called an equality. And also when different pairs of numbers, when they are added, you are getting the value same. So that means all these 3 expressions are equal to each other. Either you can write this as 8 plus 5 is equal to 10 plus 3, 8 plus 5 is equal to 12 plus 1, 10 plus 3 is equal to 12 plus 1, or 12 plus 1 is equal to 8 plus 5. Any way you can write, because the answer is, value is same, that is 13. So you have satisfied the answer of the question, first question, that is using bracket. So I have written all these pairs of numbers using bracket. Write 3 pairs of numbers whose sum is 13. So I got 3 pairs of numbers whose sum is 13. Fine, and use them to write 3 equalities. So I have written 3 equalities also. So this is 1 equality, 2nd equality, 3rd equality. So all 3 of them are equalities. Even these are equalities. Okay, students. Now we will go for the next problem. Okay. Next question I'll read out for you. Find 4 pairs of numbers. Okay, find 4 pairs of numbers. 1 for each of addition. So addition you have to do 1. 2nd, subtraction. 3rd, multiplication. The 4th pair should be division. So that they make the number 18. Write the equalities for each of them. So it is similar to the first one. But in the case of first problem, we have done only addition. Now here you are asked to do all the 4 mathematical operations, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So one of each one of them, and all of them should have the answer is equal to 18. So let's design the pair of numbers whose answer or value will be equal to 18. So it's not necessary that whatever answer I am giving, you have to write the same answers. You can have your own pairs of numbers, because it can be, you know, here different numbers can be used to get the answer is equal to 18. So let's try now to get the number 18. Okay, students. So first I will write equal to 18, 2nd equal to 18, 3rd equal to 18, and 4th equal to 18. Now, in the first one, we have to do addition. So let's try addition first here. So I can take this as 10 plus 8. is equal to 18, isn't it simple? I could have also taken 16 plus 2, 14 plus 4, correct? So all of them will give the same answer, that is equal to 18. Now let's see, next one is subtraction. We have to get 18 answer after subtraction. So what I can do, simplest way is 20 minus 2. So what I can do here is 20 minus 2 will also give you 18, correct? Now what else I can do? I could have done this as, 24 minus 6, also 18 will be the answer. 22 minus 8, 22 minus 4, you could have got the answer 18. So anyhow you can do it. Now next one is multiplication. We have to do multiplication. How we can get? We can get 18 multiplied by 1 is 18. 9 multiplied by 2 is also equal to 18. 6 multiplied by 3 is also equal to 18. So right, you have learned about factors. So you can use the pairs of numbers or factors which can give you the answer after multiplication is 18. So I take this as, 9 multiplied by 2 is equal to 18. You could do it 18 multiplied by 1 also 18. Or maybe 6 multiplied by 3 is equal to 18. Now I could get this answer 18 by dividing. How can I do this? I can get this by 36 number, right? 36 divided by 2 is also equal to 18. Okay, 36 divided by 2 is equal to 18, or 18 divided by 1 is also equal to 18, and so on. So you can get, different pairs of numbers whose answer may be equal to 18. So isn't it very easy, students? Yes, because here you have, a lot of flexibility to write the pairs of numbers whose answer will be 18. So it is your own answer you can write, not that whatever I have given you to write. Fine. Now the next part of the question is, write the equality for each of them. Okay. So let's try to write the equality. So first of all, these are equalities only, right? So we will write now more number of equalities for each one of them. So each one of them, that means what I can do, 10 plus 8 is equal to, 10 plus 8, remember to write them in the bracket, is equal to 20 minus 2. Okay, I can write 10 plus 8 is also equal to 9 multiplied by 2. Also, I can write this as 10 plus 8 is equal to 36 divided by 2. So, this means that 20 divided by minus 2 is also equal to 10 plus 8. 9 multiplied by 2 is also equal to 10 plus 8. 36 divided by 2 is also equal to 10 plus 8. So no need to write it again because here it is already written. What can be the fourth pair, fourth combination? I can have this combination, these two combinations. Okay. That is 20 minus 2 can be written as 9 multiplied by 2. Okay. I can also write 20 minus 2 as 20 minus 2 is equal to 36 divided by 2. What else I can have? I can have this last combination, that is 9 multiplied by 2 is also equal to 36 divided by 2. Okay. See that when you are writing equalities, you will always write them in the bracket. Open bracket, close bracket. Okay. So remember to write, don't forget to write these brackets, because we have learned that it is convenient to write them in the bracket. And when we write them in the bracket, we mean that this is one expression or one term. Okay, one expression or one term. So you have to compulsorily write them in the bracket to show the equalities. So this is regarding the second question, which I have tried to solve for you. Okay, so you can see all the numbers I have written. All the pairs of numbers, all the expressions I have written in the form of even equalities. So all of these are called as equalities. So I hope so you have understood about what is meant by equality, what are meant by terms or expressions, how we can get with the different pairs of numbers the same value.
we have done the different operations to find out the same value also of the different pairs of numbers. So next time what we are going to learn is about inequality. Okay students, so what I want you all to do is that whatever I have taught in this video, you need to write that in your CW book. Okay students, thank you very much.